Hello students, let's start our new topic, broader meaning of democracy. The meaning of democracy is representative democracy, representative government. The representatives in democracy, they are elected by the people. They are elected to legislature. The main function of the legislature is to make laws. The lawmaking body for the central government is parliament. The parliament which makes law for the entire country. The legislature at the state level is another body, that is legislative assembly, Vidhan Sabha, which makes law for the state. This representative, the representatives in the democracy who are elected by the people, they form the government. Their main function is to form the government and govern. They govern the people who are elected. Next. Difference between democratic and dictatorship government. We are familiar with the democratic government. We know the features of democracy. So we do not know the demerits or the problems of the suppressions or the depressions people face in dictatorship government. Now let's start to know what is going on in dictatorship and compare that with our democratic government. In democracy, power lies in the hands of people. Who holds power in democracy? People, janata. They have more power because they form the government, they make the government, they decide the government. Who will govern them will be decided by the people. Whereas in dictatorship, power lies in the hands of an individual, because dictator is a person, one person who decides what will be decided and what will be the decision of the nation, how the administration will run and what will be implemented in the nation. He decides. He never looks on the interest of the people. He never asks the opinion of the people, because he is a dictator. There is one man show. No need to know the opinion of the people in administration. So this is the point that distinguishes democracy from dictatorship. Power lies in the hands of people in democracy. Second difference. People has right to choose the government through election. Election, that is a big process. It is a celebration of democracy. We also celebrate election. And we also know about the procedures of election. Election campaigns are there. So in democracy, it is a big festival. But election. So what do people do here? People choose their representative who form the government. Whereas in dictatorship, there is no such luxury. There is no such election to elect the representative, because the representative is already there. He is not a representative. He is a dictator. And superpower vested in that person. People do not have the right to choose the government. Whatever be the rule of the country will be silently accepted, accepting the people. They can't do anything. There is no choice or option before them. If governance is good, good for them. If it is against their interest or not good for them, they will accept or suffer silently. Can't we expect such acceptance in democracy? No, never. Nobody will accept it because power lies in people. We help the representatives to form the government. Actually, we choose the government, isn't it? We choose the government. Next reference. A difference is that people enjoy freedom of speech and expression. In democracy, there is freedom of speech. Who enjoys it? People. People have freedom of speech and expression. Whereas in dictatorship, people do not have any such rights. There is no freedom of speech. There is no freedom of expression. Opinion of the people are crushing there. Crushing the opinion of the people. Not getting any right to express their views. No suggestions will be given to the government. They have no right. Next, in democracy, all citizens are equal. In the eyes of law, before rule, all are equal. There is no difference between rich and poor. All citizens are equal. Whereas in dictatorship, there is no equality. People are treated differently. Means there is treatment difference for rich and poor. Obviously, we can see such differences in dictatorship, but in democracy, these things are absent. People will not allow, because democratic government is working within the limits of constitution. The constitution guarantees rule of law and rights of citizens. Rights of the citizens will be protected. Next, in democracy, policies are made for the benefits of the people. Who makes the policy in democracy? Government. And they make policies for whom? They made policies for the people. So the policies which are made by the government for the people are good for them. So the policies of the government for the benefits of the people only. So you know that democratic government is a welfare government. Democratic government takes care of the welfare of the people. They are not working for the welfare of the rulers. Welfare of the people. Whereas in dictatorship, policies are made for the benefits of an individual. Here the rule is for the benefit of individual only. He works, he rules for the benefit of him. So these are the differences between democracy and dictatorship. I think this topic is clear for you. Or if there is any doubt related to it, you can mail your doubts. Next, we will start this chapter from beginning with the help of NCERT. Okay? What is democracy? Why democracy? Please go through the pages of inserting. Yes, definition of democracy is very clear to you. What is democracy? It is a form of government where representatives are elected by the people, and the elected representatives are accountable to the people. Yes, it is very clear. Is it clear or not? Please read it. These are examples of it. Activity is given there. Just read it. See, simple definition is given there. Please read it. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. Cartoon, and also go through the cartoons, because the pattern of question paper has been changed. So each and every pictures or cartoons given in NCERT book is also important. Questions may be framed from these cartoons also. Okay. Then second topic of this chapter is given in NCERT is features of democracy. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. First feature, major decisions by elected leaders. Means decisions are taken by elected leaders. So here example of Pakistan is given there. Musharraf led a military coup in 1999. Already we discussed this topic with the help of slides. Very clearly I explained this topic to you, how Musharraf captured power from a democratically elected government in Pakistan. So after became the ruler of Pakistan, or after capturing power from the Prime Minister of Pakistan, he increased his power by issuing legal framework order. And he also changed his designation. He was a military chief, army chief. When he captured power, military coup means capturing power from government, military coup, illegally. Later he changed his designation to president. He was a military chief, but after became the ruler of Pakistan in 2002, he changed his designation from army chief to president of the country in 2002. He held a referendum in the country. What do you mean by referendum? That is an open voting system to know about the opinion of the people. He conducted a referendum to know the opinion of the people. That granted him a 5-year extension. In 2002, he held a referendum. Through referendum, there was no election, only through referendum. What did he do? He granted 5-year extension. He got extension of 5 years also through referendum. Pakistani media, human rights organizations and democracy activists said that the referendum was based on decisions. Miss Pakistani media and all prominent organizations, they asserted that referendum was based on decisions, because no one was dared to oppose the government or the leader. The power to take a final decision rests with army officials, with General Musharraf. Final decision power goes to army officials. because there is no representatives of the people. And these army officials led by General Musharraf, who has become the president of Pakistan. This happens. Yes. This happens in many dictatorships and monarchies. This is not a new thing. It happens in almost all democratic countries. In monarchies also, it is happening. It happens. They formally have an elected parliament and government, but the real power is with those who are not elected. Actually, these countries also have some representatives, but they do not have any power. The power rests with the leader or the person or an individual who is not elected by the people. Next topic. Yes, the conclusion of this topic is that in democracy, the final decision making power must rest with those elected by the people. This is the main feature of democracy. So the above example said that there is no democracy in that situation. There is dictatorship only. So that practices are against of democracy. Next, free and fair electoral competition. In this context, there is, you know that in democracy, there is free and fair election procedures are there. It is conducted by election commission. But in China, you know, elections are regularly held there after every 5 years for electing the country's parliament like ours. The parliament of China is called Quanguo Renmin Dai Biao Daui. That is Chinese name, that is National People's Congress. Like our parliament, National People's Congress, that is the parliament of China, where elections are held after every 5 years. But the National People's Congress has the power to appoint the president of the country. The National People's Congress appoint the president of the country. It has nearly 3,000 members. How many members? 3,000. There are 3,000 members elected from all over China. Some members are elected by the army. Before contesting elections, a candidate needs the approval of the Chinese Communist Party. So, those candidates who wants to contest election needs to get the approval of the Chinese Communist Party. Otherwise, the candidate cannot contest the election for the parliament. In our country, such practice is not seen there. Is there any political party gets the approval of other party or from the government? No, because in India, there is an independent election commission is there. It gives approval for political parties to contest election. No political party needs to get approval from the government or from any big political party to contest election. But in China, the Chinese Communist Party is the biggest party who gives approval to other parties and will decide who contest election or which party contest election. only those who are members of the Chinese Communist Party, Chinese Communist Party, that is the biggest party of China, those who are members of the Chinese Communist Party or 8 smaller parties allied to it were allowed to contest elections. So who contest elections, or which parties contest elections in China? The Chinese Communist Party members or other 8 smaller parties who are allied to this party. Which party? Chinese Communist Party are allowed to contest elections. This practice was held in China in 2002-03. The government is always formed by the Communist Party. The Communist Party always elect the president of China. Another example of this non-democratic electoral practices is in Mexico. Mexico, after became independent in 1930, they also hold elections after every 6 years. Means their interval of election is 6 years for electing their president. The country has never been under a military or dictator's rule. It means that is a democratic country. But until 2000, means 70 years, every election was won by one party only. Every election, all the 70 years, only one party won the election. That is PRI. PRI, that is Institutional Revolutionary Party. This is the political party running the government of Mexico since 1930. Only one party. It means there is no opposition party in Mexico. No party is contesting election. No. Definitely, opposition parties are there. And they also contest elections. But what happened after that? Yes, but these opposition parties never manage to win. Why? Why they don't manage to win? The PRI, the Popular Party of Mexico, was known to use many dirty tricks to win elections. There is foul play in election process. What is that foul play in Mexico in elections? All those who were employed in government offices had to attend its party meetings. Government officers or the people who are working in government offices, they had to attend party meetings. But in India, you know that government servants have no political party. They can't show the support of any political party. This is our practice. They should be neutral. And even teachers of government schools used to force parents to vote for the PRI. Teachers canvassing the parents to vote for PRI. Media, whether it is print media or visual media, largely ignored the activities of opposition political parties. Means the opposition of the political parties are never shown through media. Sometimes, this is very interesting thing in Mexico, not happening anywhere. Sometimes the polling booths were shifted from one place to another in the last minute. Is it possible? Is it a good practice? Is it a fair election? Why do they do these things? These things are practicing to confuse the voters. It means they think and they decide. No, all the voters will not reach the polling station, polling booth. old voters can't reach there, they can play foul game there, which made it difficult for people to cast their votes. The PRI, the Popular Party of Mexico, spent a large sum of money in the campaign for its candidates. So all unfair practices are following this party to win the election. That's why they remained in power 70 years. That is not a short period of time. That is a big period of time in democracy. Only one party rules the country, ruled the country. So we can see that definitely there was dictatorship government. And people, even if they want to change the government, they are incapable. They can't change the government because the system of their election process are totally controlled by the ruler or on only one political party. So the examples, above examples of China and Mexico, teaches that there is no democratic practices in these countries. So the practices of these countries are against democracy. Third feature, one person, one vote, one value. Here, with the help of examples of these countries, we'll clear the topic in detail. That is, in Saudi Arabia, women do not have the right to vote. Now, recently, the practice has been changed. Women is getting the right to vote. Not like in our country, but some extent, it is granted to them. Another country, Estonia. Estonia has made its citizenship rules in such a way that the people belonging to Russian minority, Russians are also there in Estonia, where minority Russians find very difficulty to get the right to vote. It means they are not getting right to vote. So this is also against the principle of universal adult franchise. In Fiji, South American country, Indian Fijians are in large number there. But the Indian Fijians, their voting right is less valuable in comparison to the indigenous Fijians. The indigenous Fijians are the local Fijians. Local Fijians, they have more voting rights. The vote of these people are more valuable than the vote of Indian Fijians. From these practices, it is very clear that these countries are not practicing one vote, one person, one vote system. So the conclusion of this topic is that we are comparing it with a democracy. In a democracy, each adult citizen must have one vote and each vote must have one value. Next feature. As you know, children, we are going in detail with these features with the help of NCERT paragraphs. Please go through it minutely, clearly. Rule of law and respect for rights. You know that democratic governments are working within the limits of law. That is constitution. And in democracy, there is respect for rights. Whose rights are respected here? The rights of citizens. Example, Zimbabwe. I explained in very detail what was going on in Zimbabwe about the ZANU-PF. You heard it very detail. I'm not going in detail with the ZANU-PF or Zimbabwe. Robert Mugabe ruled the country continuously from 1980, and his government played all foul games to win the election. Robert Mugabe uses unfair practices in elections. Over the years, his government has changed the constitution several times. Why did his government change the constitution? For increasing his power. Whose power? For increasing the power of the president and make him less accountable. As you know, democratic government is accountable. Democratic government is a responsible government. To reduce the accountability, what did he do? He amended the constitution many times to make him less accountable. Opposition party workers are harassed here. Their meetings were disrupted or disturbed. Public protests and demonstrations against the government are declared illegal. They made illegal if there is any public protest or demonstrations against the government. They will not welcome such practices. There is law that limits the right to criticize the president. They made a law. There is a limit for criticizing the government. People can't criticize government in any way, or whatever they want to speak about the president is not welcome there. Television and radio, that is, visual media, are controlled by the government. Why? To give only the ruling party's version. Only these visual medias will show only the version, only the decisions or the policies or whatever be the good things they are taking in administration, only show that. There are yes, independent newspapers were there, but the government harasses those journalists who go against it. The journalists who goes against the government decisions or who wants to show the actual picture of the government were harassed there. It means there was no media freedom. There was no freedom for medias. The government has ignored some court judgments. You know that in every democratic government, judiciary is independent. Executive or legislature have nothing to do with the decisions of court or judiciary. It is independent because it works independently and it takes decisions. So people believe in judiciary then. There, in Zimbabwe, court decisions or judgments are influenced by this ruling party that went against it and has pressurized the judges. They pressurized the judges for giving favorable judgments. So, the example of Zimbabwe shows that there is no democracy there. Democracy is there, but in practice, there is dictatorship. Next. Summary of definition. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. Yes, here we are going to summarize the topics which we discussed now. Rulers elected by the people take all the major decisions. So this summary is the features of democracy. Features. Okay. Elections offer a choice and a fair opportunity to the people to change the current rulers. So election gives an opportunity to people to change their rulers. This choice and opportunity is available to all the people on an equal basis. That is, one person, one vote, one value, or political equality will be there. The exercise of this choice leads to a government limited by basic rules of the constitution. Means the power of the government is controlled by constitution. No government can overrule the constitution. Okay. So these are the main features of democratic government. Now next topic, why democracy? Yes, we discussed a lot about why democracy, arguments in support of democracy as well as against democracy. Here, in arguments against democracy, leaders keep changing in a democracy. This leads to instability. What instability? Political instability. If leaders are changing every time, can we expect any good governance? No, not at all. Democracy, second point, democracy is all about political competition and power play. There is no work except power play. Those who are more powerful and influential will come to power. They form the government. And eligible candidates, those who are less influential and less wealthy, never be elected. There is power play only. So many people have to be consulted in a democracy, that it leads to delays in democracy. Another point is that because of consultation with many people before taking a decision, it leads to delays. There is delaying of decisions. This is another demerit of democracy. Next, elected leaders do not know the best interest of the people. What people likes, what they do not like, leader never tries to know. Leader does not know. So sometimes this ignorance leads to bad decisions. Next, democracy leads to corruption, for it is based on electoral competition. Because in democracy, everything is competition. So corruptions take place there. There is a big chance to do corruptions, to winning election. People use any dirty game to come to power. Ordinary people don't know what is good for them, because they are less aware about political activities. So they can be cheated easily by these political big powers. And definitely they are cheating. So they don't know what is good for them. They should not decide anything. They simply accept the decisions of these leaders, representatives. Next topic, arguments. In favor of democracy, arguments in favor of democracy. So why democracy should be there? That is, arguments in favor of democracy. Here, China's famine of 1958-1961 was the worst recorded famine in world history. There, what is famine? Akal, shortage of food grains. Nearly 3 crore people died in this famine. During those days, India's economic condition was not much better than China. Yet, India did not have a famine of that kind. Economists think that This was a result of different government policies in the two countries. India had also famine situation of that period, but the situation was not so crucial like China. That was due to the differences in their government policies. The existence of democracy in India made the Indian government respond to food scarcity in a way that the Chinese government did not. When there was a situation of food scarcity in India, the government of India responded positively towards that, whereas Chinese government did not. It points out that no large-scale famine has ever taken place in an independent and democratic country. China too had multi-party elections. An opposition party and a press free to criticize the government, then so many people may not have died in the famine. This example brings out one of the reasons why democracy is considered the best form of government. Because in democracy, people's reactions and responses are welcomed. According to the decisions or demands of the people, response of the people, government will change their policies, will act in that direction. Whereas in China, no such opportunities are getting. So such problems will not be controlled easily. So the point here is that a democratic government is better government because it is more accountable. Whatever be the problems of the people will be solved easily, and if the policy of the government is not good, the people will protest against them. So government will be highly careful while taking any decisions, so they are accountable. Thus, democracy, you know that. Another reason why democracy is better, there is a fair decisions. There is a quality of decision-making process. What is it? Quality of decision-making process. Democracy is based on consultation and discussions. There are discussions and consultations with the different leaders in democracy. Before taking final decisions, they consult with many people. Many rounds of discussions are there, debates are there. On the basis of discussions and debates, they will come to a conclusion that what is good for the people, and they pass on. So we can expect in democracy, which improves quality of decision making process. Next thing is that democracy enhances the dignity of citizens. You know that, not before going this topic, one more topic is there, that is the point is here that democracy provides a method. This is the point. Next point. Democracy provides a method to deal with differences and conflicts. Explain, elaborate the statement. If question is asking this way, how will you write? That is, democracy provides all the citizens. Democracy provides all the citizens some basic rights through which they can give their opinion. Democracy provides a chance to all the citizens to choose their representatives and change them if they are not working for them. In parliament, all the members have the right to give their opinion, because different members are from different parties, there is no necessary, everyone should have the same opinion on same issues. Definitely, there are differences among them, or there are differences of opinions related to major issues. So these differences should be corrected, and there are conflicts are there. So these conflicts and differences are discussed in detail and will come in conclusion. Democracy provides the citizens a right to follow any religion also. There is freedom of religion also in democracy. So each religious people are equally respected and free to follow their religion in their own way, because India is a secular country. Secular. Next point, democracy enhances the dignity of citizen. This is the last point which I want to explain with you. That is, you know that democracy is based on the principle of political equality. So every person is dignified there, respecting them. So citizens, whether rich or poor, educated or uneducated, have the same status. People are not subjects of a ruler, they are the rulers themselves. Here the people are the rulers themselves. They are not the subjects of the ruler. This is representative democracy. This is not monarchy. So in a non-democratic country, people are killed or injured while protesting against the rulers. In non-democracy, such things are not safe. That's all. This is about the points related to arguments in favor of democracy. So democracy is necessary. Because of all these points, it is very clear to us that why we should have democratic government. That's all. This chapter is completing here, and you can revise the assignment questions. Please read NCERT text, this chapter, at least 5 times, each and every point minutely, underline many main points, and read in detail. If there is any doubts related to the topics which we discussed all the 3 days, from Monday to Friday, Monday to Friday. Okay. You can mail your doubts. Definitely, I will help you to clear your doubts. Okay. Thank you, children. You attend any video?